Kia ora koutou, Dobere Utra, Hirch Morai, and good morning, East City Core family. I pray that you're well, and I'm fully expecting that all of you will be rocking your level 3 haircuts this morning. You feeling a bit tired of level 3? I think it's beginning to weigh on me a bit. I was thinking about it this week, and I came to the conclusion that it's not so much the fact that I have no control over the situation. After all, disciples of Jesus have given up control over their lives anyway, or at least we're working toward that. But what I think is tiring to me is the clash of beliefs over how we should approach this situation, that is COVID, and the way that those beliefs are being expressed. I think if all our churches and indeed our whole population was able to follow the example of Jesus, I suspect that we would be all a lot less tired. Philippians 2 and verses 3 and 4 says, "Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit, but in humility consider others better than yourselves. Each of you should look not only to your own interests, but also to the interests of others." So yes, level 3 is tiring, but there are silver linings. Joe and I received letters from Jamie, Jordan and Mackenzie this week, which was really cool. And Jordan likes passing the rugby ball with Dad. For Jamie, he likes making cake and pizza, doing schoolwork on the computer, getting coins, and going out for walks. And Mackenzie, she likes making Mum's bed. I imagine Mum likes that too, Mackenzie. Well done. And seeing her friend on Zoom. So if any of the other children from Kids Church would like to write to us, then you can get Mum or Dad to email it to us, and we'll reply. Just tell us what you like about lockdown and what you don't like. For Jamie and Jordan and Mackenzie, they don't like not being able to visit friends, and that's fair enough. And they miss going to school and to church. So this morning, we'll bring some kids' church to you. So here's Bex, Isaiah, and Lucy.
Good morning, kids. I hope you're all keeping well. In Oasis today, you would have been learning about the Ten Commandments. These are the rules that God gave us to help us live our lives in the right way. Rules are a big part of our lives. You may have rules at home, you'll have rules at school, and at the moment we have the COVID rules, wearing a mask when we're out in public, and social distancing. All these rules are there to keep us safe and on the right track. You may not like some of the rules that you have at home, but your mum or dad will have put these rules in place to actually make our lives better. So, last week I sent you all a commandment banner, and on them are the rules that God gave us. Let's read these together.
Number 1, don't have any other God but me. Number 2, don't make idols. Number 3, don't misuse God's name. Number 4, keep the Sabbath day for rest and worship. Number 5, honor your father and mother.
Number 6, don't murder. Number 7, be faithful to your husband or wife. 8, don't steal. 9. Tell the truth. 10. Don't wish for other people's things.
Yep. So have a think which of these commandments you think is the most important. Lucy, which do you think is the most important?
I think it will be tell the truth.
Isaiah, what about you?
Don't murder.
Well, that was a question that someone asked Jesus to try and trick him, but he gave a great answer. You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. A second one that's equally important is love your neighbour as yourself. Take a moment to arrange your banner into a heart shape. Now place a hand inside your heart that you've created and think about one way that you'll love God this week and one way that you'll love someone in your bubble. Remember that God gave us the laws to protect and guide us. Use your banner as a conversation starter with your family. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you that you gave us the Ten Commandments to help us and guide us through our life. We thank you that we have rules in our lives to guide us and protect us. And I ask that when we don't like the rules or feel like following them, that we will ask you to remind us that they are there to keep us safe. Lord, I ask that you will continue to be with Tyler, Amelia, Jamie, Jordan, Mackenzie, Nixon, Lucy and Isaiah during this difficult time of being away from school and friends. I ask for your peace and patience to be upon them and that they will manage to enjoy the school holidays in some way. In Jesus' name we ask this prayer. Amen. Take care everyone, and I hope that I get to see you all real soon. Bye!
Bye!
Bye.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. All around the neighborhood, I'm gonna let it shine. All around the neighborhood, I'm gonna let it shine. All around the neighborhood, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine. Hide it under a bucket bar. I'm gonna let it shine, gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bucket bar. I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bucket bar. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. this new light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Good
morning, everyone. I wish we were there with you, but we're here, unfortunately, in a cold Lancashire and a grey day it's been. We sent two videos. I don't know if you've seen them yet, but the first one is of our original church called Mount Zion. The second one is of the church plant that we go to called New Hope. Fisher, I got it. I'm going to give you all a treat. I'm going to read from the Milnes and Boone version of Corinthians. And it's Corinthians 13, starting at verse 4. Love is very patient and kind, never jealous or envious, never boastful or proud, never haughty or selfish or rude. Love does not demand its own way. It is not irritable or touchy. It does not hold grudges and will hardly even notice when others do it wrong. It is never glad about injustice, but rejoices whenever truth wins out. If you love someone, you will be loyal to him, no matter what the cost. You will always believe in him, always expect the best of him, and always stand your ground in defending him. All the special gifts and powers from God will someday come to an end, but love goes on forever. Love to you all.
Hi, everyone. I hope this finds you safe and all well. I know at the moment it must be frustration in a period of lockdown, but believe me, matters could get worse. In this country the other day it was mentioned that in 24 hours there were new infections of 36,710 people, followed by which there were 182 deaths. That was in a 24-hour period. So if you are feeling frustrated at lockdown, just think you're probably still in the best place you can be. So, as Maureen mentioned, we're involved with two churches here, and you've seen the videos. All the churches must be affected in COVID. With one of the churches, there was normally about 20 people at New Hope who attended each week, and about a dozen children. Unfortunately, we've lost all the children, so just about 10 people now attending. And at the other one, Mount Zion, there the congregation would normally be about 60, but that's now reduced to about 20 at best, although they are still doing services online. So it's difficult times for everyone, and of course you have important work on the food bank, and we do pray blessing upon your work there, and indeed upon your church. And if I may, And I invite you, if we can all join together in a word of prayer. Lord, we come before you as a body of your people who place their reliance upon you. And as we come before you, we claim your promise that where two or three are gathered together in your name, you are with them. And so today, we know we have the assurance that you are with us. And as we are together, even though we're separated by some 12,000 miles, it's of no matter. You are mighty. You are omnipresent. And we humble ourselves before you. And in your presence, we lay before you our concerns, our worries for ourselves, but in particular, the three churches whom we represent, being East City in Auckland, Mount Zion at Cliviger, and New Hope at Burnley. You know the difficulties experienced by each of these churches over the past year, difficulties that still exist, and we will pray that your blessing may be with each church and with each individual. Lord, in our weakness, give us your strength. In your precious name we pray. Amen.
Can I just say, everyone, we'll be back soon. So if you could pray that Jacinda will open the borders sooner rather than later, and then we can come and all be with you again. Take care.
Bye.
Bye.
Hi, guys. Today's reading is taken from Psalm 100 of the New Living Translation. But first, let's pray. Lord, as we hear your word, open our hearts and minds so that we may know, love, and understand you better. Amen. Psalm 100, a psalm of thanksgiving. Shout with joy to the Lord, O earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him, singing with joy. Acknowledge that the Lord is God. He made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His unfailing love continues forever, and his faithfulness continues to each generation. Amen.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, O my soul, oh my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship your holy name. to render. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul, I'll worship Your holy name. And on that day when my strength is fading, the end draws near and my time has come, still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul, I'll worship Your holy name. I'll worship Your holy name.
As you can see, I have some unusual attire on today. I purchased this onesie in June when it was getting a little bit nippy. This onesie is soft, warm, and I feel comforted when I wear it. For today, the onesie serves as an object lesson in looking after ourselves. It's always important to look after ourselves, but I think we need to be even more intentional in our level 3 lockdown. As disciples of Jesus, we look to Him as our role model. Jesus looked after Himself physically. Jesus looked after Himself emotionally. Jesus looked after Himself spiritually. Even as Jesus looked after His whole self, His ministry also reflected a holistic approach. And throughout the Bible, we see examples of spiritual, mental, and physical health being intertwined. All these dimensions are important. One of Paul's benedictions was holistic. May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Thessalonians 5:23. So let's think practically about how we can look after ourselves in these challenging times. Be physically whole. Eat well, sleep well, exercise well. Respecting our bodies, including their limitations, is a way God communicates His counsel and will to us. Our tiredness reveals that we are not infinite beings. We need rest. We need to know that what we can do sometimes, we cannot do all the time. Christians can't expect unrealistic and special privileges and favors from God. We can't expect God to prevent sickness regardless of how we take care of our bodies or whether we follow the doctor's advice. We live under the same natural laws as our non-Christian friends. Certainly God can prevent sickness, but we shouldn't look on God as a magic charm that should make us immune to everyday problems. 1 Corinthians chapter 6 and verses 19 and 20 says, "Do you not know that your bodies are temples of the Holy Spirit, who is in you, whom you've received from God? You are not your own. You were bought with a price. Therefore, honor God with your bodies. Encourage rather than neglect yourself. Value yourself as Jesus values you. Be physically whole. Engage your mind. Keep your mind active and spend time learning from Scripture. Romans 12:2, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of the mind. This is what Dallas Willard says. The ultimate freedom we have as human beings is the power to select what we will allow our minds to dwell upon. It is in our thoughts that the first movements toward the renovation of the heart occur. Our mental and emotional well-being affects everything we do, how we process things, how we respond in situations, and how we engage with the world around us. It's so important to take care of this aspect of our lives. Engage your mind. Be well in spirit. Confess your sins. Seek freedom from addictions that destroy your health and relationships. It is tough to tackle addictions. In the first place, it is hard to admit you have one. Here's what Hebrews 12:1 says, throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles. Live with a clear conscience. Spend time in God's presence. In order to live like Jesus, we need to seek out solitude or to withdraw, even when there are legitimate matters that demand our attention, even from the people we love on a regular basis, because we have the humility to realize how much we need him to fill us up. Be well in spirit. Be in community. Now, being in community has looked really different in lockdown. We have missed being apart from family members and friends. We have missed being together in the same room, worshipping together and praying together. But we have found new ways of being together, and sharing online is one of them. Choose healthy rather than unhealthy relationships. Find people you trust that you can journey with. And when we are allowed to worship in our building again, let's not be put off by any restrictions that we may have, such as not having morning tea, but let's encourage each other with the ministry of presence. Often we are able to navigate life's challenges by ourselves or with help from family and friends. However, there are times when we need to get help from the medical profession, especially in the area of COVID, where our worlds are thrown upside down. Remember, it's brave and wise to ask for help. How well are you looking after yourself? Is there anything out of balance in your life today? Are you well spiritually but neglecting your physical well-being? Or are you focusing on your physical needs but never addressing your spiritual needs? Are you in the grips of an addiction? Is your mind in a healthy state? Is there a step you need to take or a decision you need to make? Our divisional headquarters sent us out a 30-day wellbeing challenge, and a few of us are ticking off the daily activities. They range from dancing to your favourite song, to having a sugar-free day, to writing down a cherished memory. If you would like me to email you a copy of the challenge, please let me know. God cares about us, our whole selves. The challenge for us this week is to honour the way God has made us by making wise decisions that will positively affect our bodies, minds, and spirits.
Let's pray. Father God, thank you for everything that you do for us. Father God, as we reflect on the greatness that you are, the wonderful Savior, our everlasting King, Father God, you give to us so much. Dear Lord, I pray that you'll be with all of our leaders in the world at the moment. Dear Lord, that they know you, and that they make the decisions with you. Father God, I think of all the nations that are in uprise. Dear Lord, I think of Afghanistan. I think of India. I think of so many places at the moment, dear Lord, that are experiencing pain. Father God, I pray that your Holy Spirit will speak to those people there. Dear Lord, that you will become present in their hearts, that you will become present in all their words and in all their actions. Dear Lord, I pray for our East City Church family. I pray that you will be with us as we still navigate these different levels of lockdown. Dear Lord, for a lot of us, the patience is wearing thin. The strength is wearing thin of trying to get through another couple of weeks of solitude, really. Dear Lord, I pray that you give us the patience with the leaders that make these decisions, but that you also give us the courage to just soldier on, dear Lord, and keep you in front of all our decisions and all our thoughts. Father God, I pray as Joe and Ross are preparing their handover to the new officers, dear Lord, that you would be with them, that you would strengthen them. Dear Lord, and in this time of packing up and closing down, dear Lord, that they would know that you are present in all the decisions that have been made up to now, dear Lord, and that you would continue to strengthen them on their path forward going to the South Island. Dear Lord, I also pray for the preparations that the new officers are doing, the Hendersons, in establishing their way through to East City. Father God, I pray that you give us, all of us, the strength to welcome them with open arms. And dear Lord, so that they can know that they are appreciated and that they are loved. Father, I pray for every single person that is struggling with mental health challenges at this time. Dear Lord, this is a really difficult time when we feel alone, when we just can't get face to face in the normality of what we've known as being normal before. Dear Lord, I pray that you would use us to reach out to those people. But Father God, above all that, that you will know, that you will let them know that you are present, dear Lord, and that you are all that they need. Father God, thank you. Thank you for loving us the way we are. Thank you for all the mercies that you bestow on us daily. Father God, but above all, thank you that you sent your only Son to die for our sins on the cross. Amen.
Thank you, Tania, for your prayer. And so we've come to the end of this morning's service. So a benediction. Have hope, because God will always be with you. No matter where you are going or what you are doing, at school, at work, at home, God is with you. Night and day, when you connect with friends and family, and when you are by yourself, God is with you. When you are afraid or frustrated, have faith, because God is with you. When you are confident and fulfilled, have faith, because God is with you. Go into this week with faith and remember that God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit is with you and cares for you now and always. Amen.